Welcome back to the channel. In today's video we are going to look at the following WWE news and rumors. Former WWE writer criticizes Shane McMahon and Braun Strowman's segment on Raw. Another WWE intergender match teased after Alexa Bliss vs Randy Orton announcement. Drew McIntyre goes non-PG while discussing Sheamus's betrayal on Raw Talk. And the news of The Fiend returning at Fastlane to help Alexa Bliss in her match against Randy Orton. Don't forget to drop a like and subscribe for more wrestling content. Drew McIntyre still hasn't gotten over Sheamus's betrayal and ended up dropping an F-bomb on the latest edition of Raw Talk while talking about the Celtic Warrior. The past few weeks haven't been kind to Drew McIntyre. First, his former best friend Sheamus turned on him on the road to Elimination Chamber. Then, he lost the WWE title at the event following a dastardly attack by Bobby Lashley. While talking about Sheamus's betrayal on Raw Talk, Drew McIntyre couldn't control his anger and dropped an F-bomb before the censor caught him, for which he quickly apologized. McIntyre didn't get why Sheamus would attack him like a coward instead of coming at him like a man. Drew McIntyre has held the WWE title on two occasions ever since his big victory against Brock Lesnar at WrestleMania 36. He will be getting an opportunity at the coveted belt again against Bobby Lashley at WrestleMania 37. First, though, Drew McIntyre will get the chance to take on Sheamus at Fastlane and exact revenge for what he did to him a few weeks ago. If McIntyre manages to put Sheamus down, he will need to focus on Bobby Lashley, who's currently on a roll. McIntyre picked up a win over Lashley last year at Backlash, but the Almighty has improved a lot over the past year or so. He won the WWE title a short while ago after dominating The Miz on WWE Raw. It won't be an easy road towards another WWE title victory for McIntyre, and this WrestleMania outing will be one fans can't miss. It's clear that Drew McIntyre is beyond angry at what Sheamus did to him, judging by his words on tonight's edition of Raw Talk. What do you think will happen at Fastlane when these behemoths meet in the squared circle? Will McIntyre manage to topple his former best friend? Sound off in the comments. On the latest edition of the Legion of Raw show, former WWE writer Vince Russo discussed the segment between Braun Strowman and Shane McMahon from last night's episode of WWE Raw. Shane McMahon and Braun Strowman were in singles action on Raw last night. The match saw Shane McMahon viciously striking Braun Strowman with a camera multiple times and laying him out at ringside. McMahon then maneuvered Strowman onto the announcer's table and headed to the top rope from where he hit his patented flying elbow drop. Following this, Shane McMahon took out a bucket from under the ring and unloaded green goo all over Braun Strowman. Vince Russo discussed this segment on a recent podcast. Let me break this down for you. We do the camera thing, and then we do the camera thing again. This is what I'm saying while I'm watching this. How is he not busted open? How is Strowman not busted open from the camera? I get the answer to that a minute later. He can't be busted open if they put Nickelodeon green goo on him, because he could get an infection. In other words, they bypass the real heat and color, they bypass that because they thought it would be better for Shane McMahon to throw 1980s Nickelodeon goo on Braun Strowman. Do you know how ridiculous that is? Vince Russo went on to comment about Braun Strowman's reaction to the beatdown and the green goo being poured all over him. Russo reacted to Strowman's quivering lip and reaction to the beatdown. Braun did save the scene with the quivering lip at the end, laughs. Bro, listen, have you ever been beaten up and your lip quivers? Where does that ever happen? Shane McMahon is now set to face Braun Strowman at WWE Fastlane this Sunday. WWE Raw superstar Xavier Woods has taken to social media to reiterate that he still wants to face Retribution member Reckoning in an intergender match. In a post on his Twitter page, Woods responded to a tweet from WWE which confirmed the news that Randy Orton will face Alexa Bliss at WWE Fastlane 2021. The New Day member, who has repeatedly asked for a match against Reckoning recently, is still hoping that his request will become a reality. Reckoning is the only female WWE superstar in the villainous Retribution faction. Woods faced the group's four male WWE superstars in singles matches earlier in 2021. This run of matches prompted him to demand a one-on-one match against Reckoning. On the latest episode of Raw, Woods and Kofi Kingston defeated Cedric Alexander and Shelton Benjamin to win the Raw Tag Team Championship. It has already been confirmed that Woods and Kingston will defend the titles against AJ Styles and Omos at WrestleMania 37. While Xavier Woods continues to request a singles match with Reckoning, WWE has announced another upcoming intergender match. On this week's episode of Raw, Alexa Bliss challenged Randy Orton to kick her out of his life at WWE Fastlane 2021. Orton accepted the challenge, setting up an intergender match between the Raw superstars. Intergender wrestling has been a topic of debate amongst fans for several years. Although WWE often refrains from booking intergender matches, Sasha Banks recently defeated Carmella's former sommelier, Reginald, on WWE SmackDown. Triple H, WWE's chief operating officer, has previously stated that he does not like intergender matches. He explained that he believes female WWE superstars can make a bigger impression by producing high-quality matches against each other. Either way, fans will have to wait and see whether Woods will get to face Reckoning down the road. Fastlane 2021 is this Sunday, and WWE finally added three matches on the Raw before the pay-per-view. One of those matches will see Alexa Bliss take on Randy Orton. How did it come to be? On the Raw before Fastlane, Alexa Bliss gave Randy Orton an opportunity to get rid of her for good at the pay-per-view. He was quick to accept the challenge, perhaps in regret of not immolating her at the end of 2020. Perhaps the most bizarre match on a pay-per-view card we've seen in a while, here are five possible ways that Alexa Bliss vs. Randy Orton will potentially end at Fastlane 2021. The Fiend returns at Fastlane to take out Randy Orton. It's been 3 months now since we've seen The Fiend Bray Wyatt on WWE TV. His last appearance was the Firefly Inferno match against Randy Orton, that headlined TLC 2021. While there were initially questions asked about why a non-title match was headlining the pay-per-view, the finish of the bout answered that. Just to remind you, the last time Randy Orton encountered The Fiend Bray Wyatt, he set him on fire. It's been a long build between Randy Orton and Alexa Bliss to Fastlane 2021. Post TLC 2020, Alexa Bliss returned and has been tormenting Randy Orton. She vowed that The Fiend Bray Wyatt will eventually return, although Orton seems more than convinced that he won't. Naturally, this choice of a finish comes first since the entire purpose of it is to build to Bray Wyatt's big return. It was initially rumored that he would return to face Randy Orton at the Royal Rumble. But with the change in plans and Edge facing Roman Reigns at WrestleMania instead, the Viper needed an opponent. We're not sure what the ultimate payoff will be, but Fastlane will be the perfect time for The Fiend to return to WWE. The match between Alexa Bliss and Randy Orton at Fastlane doesn't even need a conclusive finish. Bray Wyatt's appearance alone is enough to warrant a non-finish. If done right, that's all fans will be talking about post-Fastlane. The Fiend takes Alexa Bliss's shape at Fastlane and destroys Randy Orton. This could be another bizarre twist at Fastlane. A couple of weeks ago on Raw, we saw a segment where Randy Orton looked at Alexa Bliss on the TV screen. Suddenly, he was shocked to see himself appear with a different voice, indicating that The Fiend has taken his shape. We could see an odd finish at Fastlane, where Alexa Bliss gets possessed by The Fiend and destroys Randy Orton the way he has done to many opponents like Finn Balor. A DQ finish and more black blood. We've seen Randy Orton have black liquid suddenly spurting out of his mouth in backstage segments in the ring. We wouldn't be surprised if the finish of the match at Fastlane ends up being Randy Orton vomiting black blood. It could even end in disqualification, which won't matter too much if the follow-up is even better. But it could be the last straw before Randy Orton goes berserk on Raw. Randy Orton immolates Alexa Bliss at Fastlane. This time at Fastlane, Randy Orton could go through with what he didn't on Raw. Raw in 2020 ended with a cliffhanger as Randy Orton was seemingly about to set fire to Alexa Bliss. Although it wasn't shown, he stopped and revealed that the moment of hesitation prevented him from doing it. A finish at Fastlane with major shock value would be Randy Orton going full circle and immolating Alexa Bliss. It would be an appropriate way to set up The Fiend's return at Fastlane. Randy Orton destroys Alexa Bliss to set up The Fiend's return. This could be a highly likely finish at Fastlane, and we would argue that this has the highest chance of happening. While there will likely be supernatural elements in the intergender Fastlane match, the chances of Randy Orton destroying Alexa Bliss are high. Just like how Randy Orton destroying The Fiend set up Alexa Bliss's return, the same could happen in the situation vice versa.